Hello everyone, and welcome to my new Dory Paint video! A couple of weeks ago, I've made a poor Cinderella doll, Cinderella in rags. And then I've told you that I was actually planning to make two Cinderella dolls, the poor one and also a gorgeous one in her ball gown, crystal shoes, you know, all the things like this. And today it's finally time for the second Cinderella makeover, and as a model for this transformation, I've decided to take exactly the same Venice doll like for the first Cinderella, because then we will be able to put these two dolls next to each other in the end of this repaint, and we'll be able to see how the same Venice doll can look as a poor Cinderella and also as a gorgeous and a rich Cinderella. So let's start our transformation, and in the beginning I'm going to remove her outfit like always and cut her hair very very short. Then I'm going to use this hair dryer on her head for about 2 minutes, and like this I'm going to make this head soft to be able to disconnect it from the body, and it will also melt the glue inside of the head, and like this it will be easier to remove the rest of the short hair that is still sitting inside. You see, I can now easily take the head off without breaking the neck, because it's always a little bit a risky business. And then I'm taking my old tweezers and I'm removing the rest of the short hair from the inside of the head. Okay, the next step is removing her face, and for this I will need my bottle with pure acetone. And now it's time for a little plastic surgery. The same like in my first Cinderella repaint video, I'm going to change the shape of her ears, because you see, it has such a leaf shape, and I'm going to turn them into regular normal ears using my knife and some sanding paper. And the same I'm actually going to do with her hands, because you see here she also has some leaves and plants and moss and something like this. So I'm going also to sand it off using sanding paper. Okay, now let's talk about her hair. In my first Cinderella repaint video, I was seriously complaining about the terrible yellow hair color that Cinderella has in the original Disney cartoon. And then many of you have said in the comments that the original Cinderella's hair color is actually strawberry blonde. And it has become that yellow because of some sort of digitalization of all these images or something like this, that it has become that yellow on DVDs and on our modern digital screens. I've decided to make my own research, and it's very interesting, by the way. Because if you just type in Cinderella hair color in Google, you will see immediately blonde written with huge letters. And if we take a look at the pictures, we are going to see that almost everybody draws, paints, cosplays Cinderella as a blonde girl. And this is actually quite funny, because if you look a little bit deeper, ask the experts, you're going to figure out that Cinderella's original hair color is really strawberry blonde. My next question was, of course, how does the strawberry blonde look on real people in real life? And it seems to be very warm, pinkish blonde, a little bit yellowish pinkish blonde. So that's why for my doll I've decided to use today this rosy saran hair. It comes like always from Retro Dolls US store, and I think it's kind of perfect color. It's pinkish, it's yellowish, it's something, yeah, something that looks like strawberry blonde, I think. I don't know, is it strawberry blonde enough? I'm not really a strawberry blonde professional, but it looks like it. It looks really like the pictures on Google. So I'm going to continue with this hair, but first of all, I'm going to cover this doll's head with a couple of layers of this light apricot acrylics. And then we're going to reroot it. Here is her new hair after a couple of hours of working. Now I will add tacky glue to the inside of the head, then I will spread it there nicely with some Q-tips, and then I will let it dry for sure for 24 hours. When the glue gets completely dry, I protect her hair with some plastic and tape, because the next step is applying a couple of layers of acrylics to the face and to the body, because you know our Cinderella just cannot be green. Meanwhile, I have already prepared the pencils and pastels, and you can see that I'm going to use very natural colors, and these colors are also very similar to the ones I've used for my first Cinderella doll repaint. And of course, to be able to draw on a rubber doll face, I've covered it with a couple of layers of this Mr. Super Clear sealant. So when all the layers of the paint and the sealant get dry completely, I start sketching her face. My Cinderella in Rags doll has a very poor and sad face expression, and she also had completely no makeup. And this time I want to make her a little bit more happy and maybe a little bit also more glamorous in some way, but not too much. So first of all, I draw the eyes and the eyebrows, then I move to the nostrils, and I also draw the line between her lips, and then after this I blush her face with soft pastels. And I want to give her approximately the same skin tone like the poor Cinderella has. Then I drew the eyes and the eyebrows a little bit more detailed using my watercolor pencils, and to her lips I add a touch of pink soft pastels. This layer I've repeated twice to get the best coverage of the pencils, and then I draw the shadows and the highlights to make the face more three-dimensional. Then I draw the bottom eyelashes and the eyeliner. And after this, I add reflections to her eyes using white acrylics. And now I'm still going to blush her body using the same soft pastels to make it match in the face tone. So now I can remove this protection from her hair, clean up a little bit the hairline, remove all this paint and sealant that we can see here a little bit on her hair. Then I will connect the head and the body back together, and then we'll talk about her hairstyle, because there is also something to talk about. So, after we have figured out the situation with her hair color, let's also talk about another disturbing detail, the bangs. Honestly, guys, when I look at the pictures from the original cartoon, I just don't understand what kind of bangs it is, really. Cosplayers online, they create all kinds of bangs, really. You can see just all styles possible. The official Cinderella from Disneyland, I don't even want to discuss, because it seems this person who was in charge for this costume and hairstyle, he had just also absolutely no idea what kind of bangs it was. I don't know, it doesn't even look like bangs to me. Nobody has these kind of bangs in real life. It looks like some wig that they put upside down, you know, or something like this, or some dead animal on her forehead. I don't know, it's really strange. But then I've simply decided to check what kind of bangs used to be popular in the 50s. And here we go, this is the Cinderella's bangs in real life. So let's try to recreate something like this on our doll, even though, you know, I absolutely hate styling bangs on rerouted dolls. But anyway, I will try to do my best here. So, and here is her brand new hair, it looks really good to me, and now let's attach the lashes, add glossy varnish to her eyes and lips, and then we will talk about the last problem for today. So, and now let's talk about the outfit. Nowadays, as you know it already, Cinderella has blonde hair and a blue dress. But the original Cinderella in the past, in the original cartoon, she used to have white dress and strawberry blonde hair. And unfortunately, I've missed this moment when I started to work on my first Cinderella, and that's why I've asked my mom to make a blue dress. And when I figured out the difference and realized my mistake, it was unfortunately already too late because the dress was already finished. And this is a really gorgeous dress. It's very difficult to make. It takes also a very long time to make. So I couldn't just tell my mom, oh, come on, please make this dress again, but in white, because I've missed there some things eventually. You know, it's like my mistake, but you please do your job again for a week. So that's why I think today we're going to have some sort of a mix doll. She's going to have the original Cinderella strawberry blonde hair, but the dress is going to be contemporary blue. And now let's take a look at my mom's work in progress video, and then we'll put this dress on our doll. So, and here is our gorgeous blue dress. Yeah, never mind, it's blue, but it's still very, very pretty. You see, it has multiple layers. Here are two layers, and here is also white underskirt of three layers. So in total, there are five layers skirt, and there is also a pair of long gloves. And there is still another important detail our Cinderella is missing, and this is of course a pair of crystal slippers. So let's make them. I will first color this pair of shoes with a couple of layers of silver acrylics, and then I will cover them completely with this gorgeous sparkly glitter. And it's, by the way, quite expensive makeup glitter, you know, safe for eyes, good for doll shoes. So, and here is finally our finished Cinderella, completely ready to meet her prince, and I think she looks absolutely gorgeous in this blue dress. Let's also put her next to our poor Cinderella that we made 2 weeks ago, because they're supposed to look like the same person, you know, kinda under different life circumstances. And I especially love this strawberry blonde hair color today. I think it works really great with her skin tone. And even the bangs look good after all. But this is of course my taste and my opinion, and now I would love to hear your thoughts. And I'm also very curious to know which version of this doll you love more, the poor Cinderella or the one we've made today. Please write it in the comment under this video, and we will see which one of these two Cinderellas is going to win. And I have no idea, honestly, which one you're going to prefer today. So guys, I really hope you've enjoyed this doll transformation today, and if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes, because it's really important for me, for my art, for my YouTube channel, you know. Of course, subscribe if you're new here. I upload doll repaint videos every week Friday, and it means that we're going to see each other already very soon in my next doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.